American capitalism is brutal, and it started with slavery. Slavery was undeniably a front of phenomenal wealth for this country. In the United States, the richest 1% of Americans own 40% of the country's wealth, while a larger share of working age people age 18 to 65 live in poverty than in any other nation belonging to the Organization for Economical Cooperation and Development.
A child who is not embraced by the village will burn it down to feel its warmth. African Proverbs. The slave who taught Jack Daniels how to make whiskey after 150 years, Jack Daniels had finally revealed that his slave was behind the world-famous recipe, America's most popular whiskey. He learned how to make the prize spirit from Nathan Green, a black man who was enslaved. Salute to Nathan Green.
Lost in space, it's your face I see constantly. I never know if I'm right or wrong. Anything, I'm like a desperate man, seeing it trying to flee to the only other part you left to me. I'm flirting with the insanity.
Anastasia's birth is linked to the tale of Damina. Damina was her mother. A slave owner raped her, and she had a beautiful, extremely beautiful daughter named Anastasia. She was the first black girl with blue eyes in Brazil. Whether or not she was separated from her mother or remained with Damina, all seemed to agree on what comes next. As she grew up, Anastasia became the obsession of the owner's son. She was extremely beautiful. It is said that all the white women around her were jealous of her, so encouraged the owner to make her wear a slave mask. As a punishment for repeatedly refusing his advances, he raped her and condemned her to wear the iron mask for the rest of her life, only removing it once a day to eat. She lived for some years before the toxicity of the metal from the mask became poisonous. Some accounts claim she was performing miracles towards the end of her life. It became gossip among the poor that she could heal. She had found in her heart to forgive the torture she had suffered, and that she even healed her owner's son of some disease. At that moment, she became a saint for many of the poor. The story of Medusa about European film, African spirituality, melanin, and black women with power. It was created by Greek society to demonize black women, specifically those involved in traditionally African spiritual practices, with the hopes of discouraging race mixing with the genetically dominant melanated masses and maintain white genetic survival. Enslaved women's bodies existed in a political arena as places of resistance. Their body took on three dimensions. First, as a site of domination acted upon and exploited by slaveholders. Second, as the subjective experience of that suffering and terror. And third, conversely, as a source of pleasure, pride, and self-expression. So while enslaved women might have taken pleasure and pride in their ability to breastfeed their own infants, their deployment as wet nurses by whites related to their first and second bodies as sites of exploitation that deprive infants of their own mother's milk. The secret codes and music slaves used to communicate. Canada was called Canaan, or heaven, or the promised land. Harriet Tubman had the code name of Moses. If you were referring to fugitive slaves, you called them baggage. Blind bondsmen indicated how many slaves were escaping. If you donated money, you were called stockholders. The station master was the keeper or owner of a house. The petter roller was someone who had been hired to recapture the slaves. They had signature songs such as Wade in the Water, Steal Away, Sweet Chariot. Follow the drinking gourd. Now let me fly. Let us break bread together down in the river to pray. Were other songs sung by the slave. Walking through the streets of the world's first ghetto, one might come across a variety of sights, the impoverished Jews confined to that quarter. Rabbis reciting elegant speeches in the Italian vernacular. Crumbling buildings, musicians singing Hebrew poems. Although Jewish life has been restricted in cities all over the world for centuries, the first so-called ghetto was declared in Venice in 1516. By and large, its establishment was a response by the Venetian government to the increasing Jewish refugee population, which had begun to arrive following the 1492. Desiring to keep its community separate, the Venetian Republican declared that the city's Jews, who made up 1% to 2.5% of the total population, were to live on the site of a former iron Boundary. Unlike the Venice ghetto, contemporary ghettos in the United States are surrounded not by walls, but by the more amorphous and ambiguous historical legacy of inequality and racism. The ghettos of our inner cities continue to isolate and restrict those who live in them. By giving the ghetto the scholarly consideration it merits from 500 years ago to today, we can better understand the full impact of that isolation. Did you know? Housing projects were designed as housing experiments, thus the name projects. They were used to see how poor people respond to living in cramped conditions. As Brother Akil says in an important book, From Niggas to Gods, there are obvious natural consequences to putting helpless creatures into conditions so cramped and desperate that few had enough resources to survive. Studies show that if you put enough rats into small boxes with nothing else to do, they'll have babies. But then they'll run out of room. Eventually, they'll begin killing each other and even eat their young. And that's what the projects, the ghetto, the hood, the trap house are all about. Spiritual insertion. When you take bold and courageous action, your consciousness expands, doors open, doors that fear-based consciousness cannot see. Free of fear, driven by love, is a portal into another dimension, a new paradigm. First and foremost, focus within. Align with your inner spirit and everything else will take care of itself. What is it that you are most passionate about? What do you love most? Go do that and do it boldly without fear. We live in a time of fear-based mental slavery. The corrupt political and economical system is a byproduct of the fear-based ego. The short-sighted greed that is enslaving humanity and destroying the planet is a byproduct of fear-based ego. Once you transcend your fear-based ego, you can free your mind and tap into the unprecedented abundance of wealth that is presently available. Do you want freedom? Do you want genuine freedom? Lose the fear of being judged, the fear of fitting in, the fear of failure, the fear of societal pressures upon you, the fear of outside pressure of any kind. The hardest thing to do is to lose the fear. That's what I'm working on now. Forget your ego. Just let it go. And it sounds so simple, but it's not. Just let go and surrender to everything. The black nation is broken. We compete against one another. We are violent against one another. We are hateful. We don't truly know a thing about a nation we built while prisoners to it. Now that we are crippled, it's believed that if deluded enough, we will cease to exist. Impossible, but a goal you will never hear. Thank you.
Everything I see is a dream, some kind of mystery to me. I'm flirting with a mother of insanity. Oh, where is my mind? Since you left me, it's been hard to find. Sure. Where is my mind? It started to rain and I felt insane. One thing's for sure, it's gonna rain forevermore till you come back to me. Please, baby, where I'm not the same. I go somewhere and can't remember how I came. I'm completely turned around, lost in space. It's your face I see constantly. I never know if I'm right or wrong, anything. I'm like a desperate man, seeing a tragic thing. To the only other parts you left to me. I'm flirting with the sun.